What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and we are going to install our operating system on our cryptocurrency mining build that we have been doing together. And today is all about plugging everything up. I already have my bootable flash drive with Windows 10 on it. I'm going to plug it into the back panel of this computer, and we're going to power the machine on. Hopefully nothing blows up, and it should boot automatically into the flash drive so I can install the operating system, push all the Windows updates, make sure I push out the drivers for the motherboard and for the CPU and for the graphics card, and then we could continue with our mining build. Okay, so I'm going to plug everything up right now together. First thing that I'm going to do is plug in our USB keyboard and USB mouse at the back of the computer. Super simple, bam. I am going to plug in my HDMI into the machine. Awesome, cool, monitor on, beautiful. Power supply at the bottom. Awesome. I have an orange cable to power on the power supply. Awesome. Flash drive. We're going to insert it in one of the 2.0 USB ports, which is going to be at the top. Excellent. And make sure you power on the power supply because there's a switch. Okay, and we're going to press the power button to turn it on. But I want to see if it boots to the operating system or boots into the flash drive, and then I could start the operating system installation. All right, so from here, we are going to click on next, install. Right now, Windows setup is starting up. That is a good thing. I'm crossing my fingers. I'm hoping that the motherboard is able to read the hard drive. Windows 10 Enterprise LTS. C, because LTSC is like a stripped down, it doesn't have like Xbox app and it doesn't have all that nonsense that I don't need. So we are going to click next here. Accept the license and terms, click next. We're going to do a custom install Windows only. Yes, it does pick up that 1 terabyte hard drive. Oh, beautiful. So we're going to select it. We are going to click on next, and that's it. Right now it is installing Windows 10 on our cryptocurrency build. I am super excited. Everything is working the way it's supposed to work. Yes, so what's the final step? So the final step is once you got your operating system up and running, make sure that you push out all the Windows updates, make sure you push out all the drivers and utilities and software for every part that you have inserted into your rig. That consists of your motherboard, all the drivers, all the utilities, all the softwares. Make sure you push out the most important driver for your motherboard, and that is your BIOS update. Make sure that you're running the latest BIOS on that motherboard. The next thing is make sure you update your graphics processor card drivers. Extremely important because you want that to run with the latest drivers. For me, I install Google Chrome. You can install Firefox, it's up to you. I do not like to use Microsoft Edge or Internet Explorer within my operating system, so my choice for browser will be Chrome. I'm still pushing out Windows updates on this machine. As you can see, I have to restart, but just make sure you push out every single Windows update. Now, once you have everything fully up to date, because this is a cryptocurrency mining build, you have to disable Windows updates. Make sure you disable that service on the operating system so your machine doesn't install a Windows update and it reboots during mining. That's a no-no. The next thing is you need to change the power settings so your machine doesn't go asleep, the hard drive doesn't go asleep, it doesn't go in hybrid mode. You don't want that, right? So make sure those two settings are configured. Now, what software that I'm using to mine, and the software that I'm actually using is Claymore Mining. It allows you to actually use an AMD or an NVIDIA card at the same time. This is what I'm using right now. I already have it installed and I already have my batch file already configured. Super self-explanatory. Just follow the instructions. You got to make sure that you right click and edit that particular batch file and just change the settings to point to the pool that you're going to be using to mine. Also, if you want to give your worker a name, you could use this attribute, eWorker. You're going to use eWallet to basically tell the batch file where's your wallet, where to send your cryptocurrency to, and that's it. Plain and simple. This is the mining software that I'm using for this rig. I'm still pushing out Windows updates. Once that's completed with Windows updates, I'm going to transfer the machine to another location where there's like an AC unit to keep this machine cool 24/7. So I'm excited about that. And then once that's done, I'm going to double click on that batch file to run the mining, and it's going to start mining my cryptocurrency for me. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this entire build with me. If you have any comments or concerns, leave them at the bottom, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.